To create a clipping mask in Procreate, you need at least two layers. First, you'll need a base layer. In my case, I'm using this pink lettering as my base. Then you'll need to add a new layer above it. On your new layer, you can paint and make whatever changes you want. To turn this into a clipping mask, tap on your layer number 2 and choose clipping mask, and you can see right away what happens. The texture that we've created on layer 2 is locked into the pixels underneath. This is great because now we can edit these layers separately from one another. So for example, I can take this orange gradient and I can adjust the position of it. I can rotate it, and I can even recolor it. You can also make changes to your base layer. So for example, if I wanted to add some additional pieces to my base layer, I could do that and the clipping mask still applies. You can also stack clipping masks on top of each other. Create a new layer, make some changes to it, tap on the layer and choose clipping mask. If you create a new layer directly above your base layer, it will automatically make that one a clipping mask too. So I'm going to hide that top clipping mask layer, and then on this layer, just make a few changes. And you can reorder your clipping masks by taking one of your layers and dragging it above the other one. You can hide them, and you can use different blend modes on your clipping masks as well to create some interesting effects. So here we looked at adding clipping masks above the lettering layer, but I want to show you another example of how you can use clipping masks. So I'm going to delete all of those layers I created, and now I'm going to make my base layer actually my clipping mask layer. I'll just call this lettering for now. So I'm going to create a new layer, rename it, and call it base. And for this one, I want to clip my calligraphy to the shape of a circle. So I'm going to draw a circle. Tap with one finger to make it a perfect circle, color drop it, and reposition my circle here. Now I need my base layer to be below my lettering layer, so I'm just going to drag it underneath. And then to clip my lettering to the base, just tap on the layer name, choose clipping mask, and now you can see it's only going to show up where that circle is. If I make changes to my base layer, for example, erasing part of it, that's also going to affect the layer above it. I can also completely clear off that layer and draw on it with a brush, and it's almost like a magic effect where that lettering is going to appear now because it's a clipping mask. And then of course you can still adjust your lettering layer. If you wanted to rotate it or recolor it, you can adjust it separately because it's a separate clipping mask layer. So that's a brief introduction to clipping masks and why you would use them. Check out our other video on alpha lock and why you would use alpha lock versus clipping mask. Hey, if you liked this video, subscribe to our channel for more and check out our other tutorials on Procreate. You also might like our free iPad calligraphy practice brush. It's a color-changing brush that helps you learn how to control your pressure as you're writing calligraphy. You can get the free brush plus a bunch of practice worksheets available on our website at lovelyloops.com/freebrush. Check the description to download yours. Thanks again for watching and happy digital lettering.